I'm leaving of my own free will and volition, despite what you may hear and we may read of, and very amicably. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here for the time I'm here. This, I'm delighted to say, is my last program. And I hope that's the last thing I hear about it, because, frankly, the subject, I got to tell you this, bores the hell out of me.
This is Larry Michael with a mini pro sports report brought to you by the Kemper National Insurance Companies, proud hosts and sponsors of this week's PGA Championship. The fourth major in golf's Grand Slam, the PGA Championship this year will be contested at the Kemper Lakes Golf Club in Hawthorne Woods, Illinois. A relatively new course by major championship standards, but one of the most beautiful and demanding in all of golf. The drama and excitement of the PGA Championship this week at Kemper Lakes in Illinois.
Jack Nicklaus, Greg Norman, and red-hot Curtis Strange are getting together to make a little noise. This week they're competing for the 71st PGA Championship at Kemper Lakes Golf Course, hosted by the Kemper National Insurance Companies. So don't miss live action of the PGA Championship Thursday and Friday on ESPN and this weekend on ABC. If you think hearing the world's best golfers is exciting, imagine seeing them live. Brought to you by the Kemper Cavalry.
Don't go away, Mad. Give Pete Franklin a call. He'll be right back after this.
Valvoline Motor Oil presents the Mets Player of the Week, Kevin McReynolds, and we'll be back in a moment. For Kevin McReynolds, two big games over the Cards and then the ultimate against the Expos.
The 1-0 pitch.
Line drive, deep left field, way back. The game's over. It's gone. Home run, Kevin McReynolds. Up into the long section in left field, and the Mets sweep the series from Montreal.
Congratulations to Kevin McReynolds, Valvoline Mets Player of the Week.
All right, thank you very much as we continue with more. Hello, hello, hello.
Hi, Pete. I'm a Yankee fan who dislikes George Steinbrenner. I think most people do. Most Yankee fans do. I'll never let George chase me away from being a Yankee fan, however. I'll always be a Yankee fan.
Good. Support your club and support the Yankees and support baseball because the sport's great. And that's what counts. And don't let that scuzz spoil it for you. Be critical of him and pine for his removal, but support your team.
But, Pete, I think that you have a special hatred for the Yankees, especially for George in particular.
I think maybe
on your last program before you leave, you ought to explain what... You must have an axe to grind somehow with George. Something in your past that
No, none whatsoever. In fact, our personal confrontations have been pleasant. When I was in the hospital before I came to New York, he even sent flowers to me. No, this is the truth. It's all been published. It's all true. It's entirely true. I have a personal hatred for Ted Stepien, George Steinbrenner, Bob Irsay, George Argus, the people who are megalomaniacs who spoil it for sports. I happen to think that sports is beautiful. I've spent a lifetime in it. I love it. I'm a fanatic on it. I happen to detest and loathe the business I'm in and love the business of doing what I do and sports. That's what's kept me in it longer than any man in history. And so anyone that usurps the authority of the professionals. It's like a guy who inherits a hospital, and he goes into the operating room and butts in when the physician is operating, and the patients keep dying because this schmuck keeps telling the surgeons to do this and that. I hate anyone who screws the Bob Lemons of this world and the Dallas Greens of this world. In other words, the professionals. I hate the amateurs who do that. I hate the powerful multi-zillionaires who are so arrogant and rotten and terrorize little people and hire and fire them and torture them. Those are the kind of people I hate. They're called tyrants if they weren't in sports, dictators. And I would hate them as I hate Castro and all the other Khrushchev and Hitler.
Do you have any regrets, in particular, the times that you called... scumbags and stuff
No. This is only sports. This is fun. The people know what I'm talking about. Where I'm chewing them out on sports, they're chewing me out on sports. It's just like if you and I were going to a ball game and you're calling me an idiot and I'm calling you an idiot and we're having fun. This is not a serious subject. But what does offend me is the guy that would destroy the sport, take the team away, and threaten the community, as some of these people have done. It's Mr. Irsay in the middle of the night, like a carpetbagger, loaded up all the merchandise and screwed the people of Baltimore, like Steinbrenner is threatening to do, take the Yankees out of the Bronx. God, the Yankees must stay in the Bronx world without end. And if something is wrong with the neighborhood, then the city of New York has got to clean the neighborhood up. But the Yankees are the Bronx Bombers. And whether I hate them or love them, they are the Bronx Bombers, and that's baseball, and that's tradition, and that I love, and that you could put on my tombstone. And anyone that would violate that is someone I hate. George Steinbrenner is a disgrace. He is like a piece of scum on apple pie. He doesn't belong there. He is a Hitler. He is the Führer. Sing it. Ah, that's George's song. Herr Steinbrenner. Let this be my legacy to Steinbrenner and New York. Take it, boys. Take it. Let's hear the Franklin Singers. Let's hear the Franklin Singers. Come on.
Wenn der Führer says,
yeah.
He is the master, eh?
Yeah.
He heil.
See,
heil.
See,
right in the pure space, not to love the Führer. He's the greatest race, so be heil. In the purest space. When her Goebbels says, we own the world in space. We hire, hire. Right in her Goebbels space. When her Goering says, he'll never bomb this place. We hire, hire. Right in her Goering space. Are we not the Superman? Aryan pure Superman.
Yeah, we are the Superman.
Super duper Superman.
Is this Nazi land so good? Would you leave it if you could?
Yeah, this Nazi land is good.
We bring the world to order. I'll hit this world to order.
Everyone of foreign race
will love the Führer's face when we bring to the world disorder. When the Führer says he is the master, eh?
Sing it.
We heil, heil. Right in the Führer's face, not to love the Führer is the greatest grace. So we heil, heil. Right in the Führer's face.
Georgie, you slob, you scumbag. Something pleasant and unpleasant. The traffic is unpleasant, but our first lady of traffic, Eileen Marchese, is very, very pleasant.
And you're very, very pleasant, too.
That's a nice way to say it.
Well, we have some troubles now on the Belt Parkway. You're heading into Springfield Boulevard. Traffic and transit conditions again at 434. I'm Eileen Marchese for the Fan Highway Patrol.
AT&T, may I help you?
I'd like to make a collect call.
Play the Gannett Westchester Rockland Newspapers WFAN Baseball Trivia Sweepstakes.
Sports Radio 66, WFAN.
All right, that man's doing it again. Ryan Sandberg hit his sixth home run in five games as the Cubbies are walloping the Phillies 9-2 in the top of the sixth. It ain't over, though. Remember yesterday? What was it yesterday? They were ahead 10-2 or 10-3, something like that, and then... wham! Turned out to be a football score. But right now, the Cubs look like they got it made. That's what we could have said yesterday, too, at the same approximate time. Hello, hello, hello.
Hey, Pete, how you doing?
Marvelous.
Hey, listen, I'm a football fan.
Mm-hmm, so am I.
Football. I got a question, though. College football. I want to know, basically, your opinion of which you think is the toughest or the most parity in college football as far as conferences go.
That's a very difficult question because that keeps changing every couple of years if you've followed it very, very closely. There was a time when the Big Ten was it. There was a time even when the Big Eight was pretty awesome, although the Big Eight has basically been two or three teams from time to time. I would say right now it could very well be the Pac-10 is getting stronger and stronger and stronger without the vast majority of America realizing, for example, the teams like Washington are very good. USC and UCLA, I think the average fan knows about. But Arizona and Arizona State are starting to happen as well. And I'm not sure that the average fan perceives that, particularly here on the East Coast, where we really don't follow West Coast football. But if the question is a parity question, then that's probably the best I can answer that. Southeast football is terrific as well, but there's usually so many weak sisters in the SEC. There's always the Vanderbilts and Kentuckys that get kicked around, but Auburn is usually awesome. Alabama has faded. Tennessee has disappeared. So that's not as strong, the SEC, as it used to be. And the state of Florida is also exploding with football talent, as you know.
Yeah, but you've got teams like Mississippi who are come up and coming.
Yes.
You've got LSU.
Yeah, well, LSU is usually very, very potent year in, year out. They're very active in recruiting because they teach basket weaving there. So they're usually very, very good as far as football is concerned and very bad as far as academics are concerned. But there's also Tulane. You know, so look at it from the true perspective. There are some great teams in the SEC, but you're asking me parity, and I think there's a wee bit more parity in the Pac-10 now. The Big Ten is also starting to get a little bit more parity now. With Illinois, you can expect to be more potent this year. I think Iowa continues to improve in the last few years to add to Ohio State and Michigan, Michigan State. That's pretty potent, but unfortunately, they also have Northwestern, which is usually a joke. And Indiana has been a joke at various times in football. So there hardly, if are any, conferences where there aren't some weak sisters that embarrass you, but I'd say the Pac-10 would be my answer to your question.
Okay, thanks a lot, Pete.
All right. That's a tough question because it's one that can change, as I said, from year to year. This year, for example, in the Big Eight, instead of Oklahoma and Nebraska, I think you should watch Colorado. Now, I'm not suggesting that Colorado is going to topple those two, but I think they'll come very, very close. Sort of like what you saw the last few years with Oklahoma State, who should go into the ash can, by the way, this year, as their program is on the way down. All right, right now we take a break for sports news, weather, traffic, back with more.
Reed nets a new job. Good afternoon, 64 degrees at 4:30. I'm John Stashauer with the latest 66 WFAN sports news. A shakeup with the New Jersey Nets. Coach Willis Reed is now Vice President Willis Reed. Not really a slap, it's a step up. An enlarging of his responsibilities. He'll be involved in the business end of the team now, involved in marketing in addition to basketball personnel. The Nets gave him a 5-year contract. Kind of strange to make such a move now and not at the end of the past season, but the Nets will now have to go out and find a replacement for Reed. The Nets, a fifth-place team last year, had a record of 26-56. All right, Ryan Sandberg is doing it again. The Cubs and Phillies battling at Wrigley Field. Let's go to Chicago, get an update from David Schuster. David, you there? He's not there. All right, I'll tell you what's going on. The Cubs are leading 9-2. Keep in mind, the Phillies came back from a 7-run deficit yesterday, but they're trailing 9-2 in that game in the sixth inning at Wrigley Field. And Ryan Sandberg has hit a 2-run homer. He has hit at least one home run in 5 straight games, and that ties a club record. One of those games, he had 2 homers. In fact, yesterday, he had 2 home runs. Of course, the standings seem to fluctuate almost daily in baseball these days. Consider that a week ago, the Mets seemed to have their backs to the wall, 7 games out of first place being occupied by Montreal. And a week later, it's the Cubs that are in first. Mets are only 3.5 out, although if the Cubs win tonight, they'll be 4 out going into their game tonight. But the Mets have made up 6 games on the Expos in a week. Two big wins for the Mets last night over the Cardinals, who are now in fourth, 5.5 out. Frank Viola on the mound at Shea tonight. The game is still on, and Viola will be making his Shea debut against the Cardinals' Scott Terry, and all the action on WFAN. Coverage begins Mets Extra, 6:35. Yankees are in Minnesota. Walt Terrell against Shane Raleigh, with Goose Gossage now back with the club. And a tough blow for the California Angels as they go into their big showdown series with Oakland this weekend in Anaheim. Shortstop Dick Schofield has a broken finger and will be out 2 to 3 weeks. A PGA update next on Sports Radio 66 WFAN. WFAN Sports, sponsored by Jiffy Lube.